Hey guys, welcome to your fifth beginner's Java tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm going to be teaching you about number variables, and also we're going to be building our first method to do something. So I'm going to create some global variables, and what global variables are is that they are accessible by any other method in the program, which brings me on to another point, and that is that variables have something called a scope. Now, oh, just got an email. Variables have something called a scope, and a scope is the region at which they can be accessed. So, for example, if you remember from last tutorial, we created a string variable called s, string s. If we put our string variable in the main method, the scope of the string is for the main method only. If we tried to access the string variable outside of the main method, we would get an error. So to make sure variables are accessible by any other method in the program, we make them global. And to make them global, there's no special syntax. You simply place the variable outside of any methods, but make sure you're still inside the class. And it's good practice, just general good practice, to put global variables at the top of your program. So we're going to create some global number variables, and now there are four main types of number variable, which I'll be explaining today, and that is integer, double, short, and long. First I'll explain the integer. To declare an integer, you write int, and then we give our integer a name. I'm going to call it integer. It could be any, you can name it anything you like, and I'm going to make it equal to 10. Now, in case you didn't know what an integer is, an integer is a whole number. So, for example, if I make this 10.5, it returns an error. So whenever you're working with ints, make sure they're only whole numbers. If you want to declare a decimal number, you use something called a double. And to declare a double, you simply write double. And I'm going to name it decimal, because what a double variable is it stores a decimal value, which could be, I'm going to make it 20.56. And then you have short and long. I'm going to name the short small and the long large, and I'll explain these in turn. Both of these variable types are integers, except the small holds numbers up to a smaller value than the integer and long do. The reason for this is that in the long run, if you're making a very large program, it will save memory due to the amount of bytes that are taken up when the variable is stored. And when I say it's small value, that's in computer terms. I think it can store to a value of about 32,000. So if you're generally working with small numbers, I would use the small value. I'm just going to make that 1. And the large is the complete opposite of that. It can store enormous values. I'm not even sure how large they can be, but they can be pretty large. I'm just going to make this 100,000. But now that we have our variables set up, actually I'll just go over them one more time. So the basic syntax for declaring a variable is the variable type, then the name of the variable, and then you can either end the statement right there to initialize the variable something else, or some place else rather, or you can initialize the variable right there by putting equal sign and then giving it a value. So an int is an integer, which is a whole number. A double is a number with a decimal. Short is a small number, and long is a large number. Now that we have our variables, we're going to make a method so we can add the numbers together. So to create our own methods, we simply write public. We want our method to be public because we want it to be used by other methods and other classes. So we'll write public, and then we need our return type. We want it to return an answer. So we don't know whether it's going to return an integer or a double or not, so we'll write double, because then it could return a decimal or a whole number. And then we're going to write a name for our method, which we're going to call add. And then after the name, you have empty parameters. and then you open your spiky bracket and then close it. And the reason it has an error is because we're missing a return statement, which we'll add in a second. So what we're going to do is we're going to write the numbers which we wish to be added together. So we're going to add all of these numbers together. So we're literally going to write it how you would imagine, and we're going to say integer plus decimal plus small and plus large, and then we can put a semicolon at the end of that. But now we need to give this a value, so we're going to call this, because we know it's going to add up to a number with a decimal, we're going to call it double. We're going to make a new variable, that is, we're going to call double answer is equal to this statement that we just made, and I'll put it on a new line so it's easier to see. Now let me explain what's happened here. We've created a method, we've created a public method that's going to return a decimal value, and we've named it add. Inside the parameter, inside the spiky bracket, we've then created a new variable called answer, which is equal to integer plus decimal plus small plus large, which are our variables up here. Now, the value of all of these added together is now stored in the variable answer. So we still have an error here because there's a missing return statement. So to return the answer, we simply write return and then what you want to return, and we want to return the answer. And as a quick side note, again, you don't need to worry about what static means at the moment, but to be able to call this method from a static context, we're going to just make it static itself. And actually, I've already explained to you about scope, so I'm just going to cut these and place them in here, because they only really need to be available to this method. Now that we've done that, let's just do that. Now that we've done that, we now have our method add, and it's a method which returns a double value, which is a decimal, and we declare all of our numbers, variables, and then we create a variable called answer, which is equal to all of them added together, which then returns the value answer. We can then print out our answer to the screen in our main method by saying system.out.println, and then in the parameters we're going to write the name of our method, because this method here returns the answer, so that is essentially its value. So add, which is the name of the method, and then you add the empty parameters afterwards. So that's all looking in check. So now I'm going to run this program up here, and as you can see in the output, we have the answer here, which is all of these added together. And that's it for this tutorial, but in next tutorial I'm going to be showing you what you can do with the parameters inside a method, and you'll find it to be very interesting and useful for when you're programming Java in the future. So thanks for watching, please subscribe.